Alright, welcome back to Mongolia, cavalry only. We're going to jump right in so that we can do a recap. Does that make much sense? Probably not. So Mongolia might look a bit bigger than you well know. Well, we absorbed quite a few countries around us. Who was here? Xinjiang? Yeah, they went away. We got rid of Shebe Sanma. I think the first one we struck was over here though, that was Shanxi. Had to eliminate all the opposition so that we could absorb some manpower. We went for Tibet as well. I think that covers everyone we went for until we decided to strike China whilst they were busy with Japan. Now, Japan claimed most in that war. That's hardly surprising since they did almost all of the work. But we did gloriously take Chongqing in the Sichuan state. But we didn't get it. It was the one thing I wanted. It had all the steel and loads of population. The population of Sichuan dwarfed my own population of 800,000. But we didn't come away with nothing. We managed to get Guangzhou, which resourcefully is even better than Chongqing Sichuan. And we also made away with Shandong. So really we came away with more than what we could have gotten out of Sichuan, since we also ended up with some ports, higher population, more resources, and finally the ability to build some ships. I don't know what a waterborne horse is, but we're going to have to make some, because paratroopers are outside of the question. Well, that's what I'm saying for now. I might have to cave in on that one later on. But I am now on holiday. I'm on holiday for today and the following 20 days, I believe. Yeah, I'm not back to work until like July the 30th, so it's going to be quite a bit of streaming. And also next week there's going to be a Hearts of Iron 4 multiplayer. The sign-up is in the link is in the title of the stream. Or at least I hope it is. Jake, it's Sichuan, not you think I know these places' names. So the situation right now, I'm at a bit of an impasse here. I got the choice. I can either nail Japan, or I can work my way west. Now, as much as I love to go west and then chant the song, I think Japan needs to be put down. There are all these Chinamen that really do need to learn how to ride a horse and then fight in my glorious army. I'm sure it's pretty obvious, but the mantra of our army is that we fight with horses and nothing but. Do these guys still have a battle plan somewhere? Yeah, that was it. And after giving it a lot more thought than I care to admit, we are going to have to go to war with Japan. I might as well solidify that idea in my head by saying, yeah, this time we're definitely going to conquer Sichuan. So, let's make that so. Now, what else is the case? I want my troops to get into position for that. There's a few things that I want to change up about my country before going so gung-ho into that. Let's make that our offensive here. I'm not focusing on anything at the moment, but I do want to start going down nationalism pretty soon. Probably more so than I need the rest of this junk, so let's start doing some collectivist ethos. That seems about right. Maybe there was a reason I didn't do it before, but that is lost on me. I also really want to change out from civilian economy to war economy. You know, it could be when I was playing this like a week ago, because I took a week off for Summer Games Done Quick, that I had all these ideas in my head, but I'm just throwing them out the window right now. Seems I recruited a load of divisions for some reason. Oh, I think I was trying to bank that manpower, wasn't I? Well, if I cancel all this manpower, I sure hope I get it back. Yeah, I probably do. Let's see, we got 33 off of 52, so there's like 20 divisions here. 20 divisions of 3,000 men. So I should get 60,000 manpower back when I click this button. I did, thank goodness. Because I got a bit of a plan here. This is our standard division template. It's the only one we've been using so far. Jake, I'm sorry to report there's a little missing between part 2 and 3 of YouTube. Oh, thanks. Could you send me that as a message so I don't forget it? Jake, when will your horses blot out the Swedish sun? Now, the Swedes will be eating salted horses for generations to come. I'm going to duplicate this. Now we've got a new division, and I'm going to give them very inspiring names. This one is going to be One Horse. And if it's One Horse, then it's just a pawn. And we have to make it so, indeed, it has only one horse. Good. I'm not sure if there are situations where I'm going to need two horses, though. Yeah, I probably should have saved it when I trimmed it down to two horses, and I could have saved myself the extra cost there, but I don't think I need two horse divisions. I will probably, however, want five horse divisions in the future. But the future is not now. All I really wanted for now were the one horses. How many do I want? As many as I can manage. Like, seriously. If that's as many as I can get going at once, how many do we have? 61 divisions. Honestly, not as many as I was expecting, but I'll take it. And that means we still have these three horse ones that are in training. Now that is acceptable to me. Additionally, we're not quite producing as much as we could. We've got a burning lack of steel and oil. I don't really care about not producing as many convoys. Now, sure, it'd be nice to make more, but we're still going to go back to Uncle Stalin and say, pretty please give me some more iron. Iron, steel, it's all the same to my eyes. Alright, I think we can unpause from there as I figure out what is going on. Exile divisions, that's fine, they'll make their way away. Except they are probably going to... They wanted to go all the way home, but now I'm just going to tell them to go here and then they can redeploy to this front line. Logistically, we're actually doing pretty good, but we are needing to produce a lot more weapons. One, we're getting on that. Again, burning lack of steel for that. I want to give them the maximum amount of steel, since I don't even use any support equipment. I would like to learn how to use some so I can give it to my divisions, but that day is not yet here. Jake, did you leave the Comintern, you know, before the Civil War? Yeah, that was on my mind, but I'm just gonna play it out. For better or for worse. Alright, lads, you need to get into position and start learning how to fight this. Doesn't seem all that balanced having a staggering 10 over here. Maybe I should make it a bit more concentrated. Since if there's one thing we absolutely need, it's to take Chongqing. Everything else is just... eh. But by that same token, can be useful to somewhat clamp around Chongqing. So we're working on that. We'll very slowly get ourselves some ships. There's a lot I need to learn. By learn, I mean research. Engineering maybe wasn't the best of options here, neither was support weapons one, since it doesn't help us much at all. Alright, so here we get the choice to go into a civil war. I think not. I think civil war would kill us, so let's put that off for a little bit, shall we? I need to be able to pull the trigger with the Soviet Union on my side, and then hopefully just drop the Soviet Union like an ugly baby. All the while, our units will train up, and they should be ready around the time that we have a casus belli on our Japanese friends. Then again, the claim only took 125 days, I think, training time for you guys. 120 days, okay, right, everything should work out just fine. It's quite nice because you barely use any infantry equipment at all. We have plenty for you, but I would still like to upgrade. None of you are in need of training. In fact, some of you are even up to seasoned or veteran, which is great. I'll give you a 75% boost on your utterly pathetic stats. If anything, you guys should be elites, the elite horsemen. Makes me a little sad that you're one division short of being a full amount. This also makes me sad. That is a scary number of Chinamen on my border. And it seems the Soviets have withdrawn completely from my lands. They will get into position, or so I hope, once we pull the trigger. There's a lot to worry about with using one horse divisions in a border like this. But I think it'll all work out. Yep. There's no assumption like baseless assumption. Alright, things are looking okay, nor do we particularly have to worry about anything, so I can just speed up. A little saddened at the lack of steel. Wish I had more, but... Huh, didn't I have some oil before? Well, we will very slowly make some convoys. It's not a particularly important thing for us right now, because we can actually produce military factories at a reasonable rate now that we went for war economy. Not only does it make it a lot faster, it frees up a lot of our civilian factories that were previously being used for consumer goods. And yeah, I think everything just needs to go straight into weapons, because we haven't researched any of our flying horses yet. There's absolutely no focus for us on planes yet, but there will be. Because the nice thing about playing cavalry only, one of the only nice things about going cavalry only, is that we can ignore all of this, and quite a lot of this. I'm going to want to research motorized, but not for fighting with. I don't need anti-tank, and these are kinda useless to support weapons. A staggering 2% boost to my cavalry. Makes me wonder why I even decided to research it. There were probably better things that I could research, like, oh, I don't know, better production efficiency, better industry. Oh well, it's only a couple of months, I'll get it done after that. No reason not to just go gung-ho right now. Oh, except we have some more units that are ready for deployment. I got no problem with that. But where do they go? There's a problem with deploying them here, in that they are just going to die. But there's something to be said for blocking these guys off, so I will throw you out here. Get rid of this altogether, I don't need more for now. There were 13 of you, eh? How about I take one of you and assign you over here so you're a full, Fool 24. Hold on, fool doesn't make sense. I made you into a field marshal. Ah, well, whatever. Let's not worry about the small stuff. I'm also going to need some new commanders here. Let's just recruit a few. And 12, eh? Welcome to your new front line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 provinces wide. Well, dig in, lads. Get into position and then please exercise your way to glory. Right, Czechoslovakia is long gone. Sucks to be them. If only they'd kept hold of the Sudetenland from what we saw in a previous campaign, that is how you make it. And good night, Zog. Oh well. Are nukes on the table, Jake? I don't know. It takes a lot of tedium out of the late game, but it itself is a bit tedious when it's ho-ho, just time for nukes. That's how you win. Alright, we've got ourselves some collectivist ethos. I'm wondering if I should just save up so that I can go for nationalism later on, or if there's something else worth looking into. Motorization effort does appeal to me, because I'll be able to research trucks super fast. That's good enough reason for me. I'm a big fan of trucks, after all. Battle truck logistics will be a thing. So what do you folk do? Not entirely sure, but how about... we give you this. Don't think they like that at all. No, not if they have to plow through that. Well, it's better to have a plan, so there you go. Low manpower, don't I know it? Might be worth just keeping the manpower we have there for now. And then we're gonna have all these one-horse units. But bear in mind, we are already at service by requirement, going for all adult serve. Well, one would require us to be at war, and two would put a big strain on both training, construction, and factory output, so not something I'm keen to jump onto, but it is likely something I'll have to do. Cavalry is utter trash. I mean, for attacking, it's just... why? Thankfully, Japan also thinks so, so they have left this place very poorly guarded. Trouble is, it would take a lot of my horsemen just to take down one of their divisions here. I really want to get some support in on my Morite Divizin, which I think I'll just rename to Three Horses for simplicity's sake. Whoop-de-doo. Alright, I think I was talking about getting some more industry going. Straight up 20% output is strictly better than getting plus 15% production efficiency. In my eyes, at least. Maybe I'm completely wrong, who's to say? But, as a clever man once said, why not both? I'd love to get some encryption-decryption going as well, since that helps in battle. But really, not terribly much can help my my men in battle. I don't think they're going to have time to finish their training before I pull the trigger. I really hope the Soviets want to help out. If they don't, then I'm going to be in a bit of a pickle. Also, I forgot, it takes extra training for you, doesn't it? Oh well, you know, it really doesn't matter if you're well-trained or not. The whole reason I have you guys here... Ka-chung. Now, how many more of these guys can I get? And is it even worth training more of them? It's always good to have some on the back burner, even if it does burn up my manpower. Also, it lets me keep a close eye on the amount of losses I'm taking here, so yes, you guys will learn this. Now, what'll I do? I want you tactfully split up into divisions of 24. And then give you guys front lines. It'd be nice to see exactly how wide this is without having to count provinces. Maybe there is a way and I'm just blind, but 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, don't I just want it to be as wide as can be, so that we have one person on each... Okay, no, apparently it's not quite as wide as I thought. I'm a little torn here. Alright, that'll do for you guys then. Get to it. In fact, I wonder if I can strategically redeploy you over there. That'll get you done faster, right? Probably. And I want another 24. So what am I doing? I don't know, I'm still trying to figure this out in my head. Since I don't think it's going to be a particularly pretty time for my horsemen. That should do you there, for now at least. No, I don't agree with that. I don't agree with that at all. I'm going to grab you, 13, make you into your own division, and give you that narrower area. That'll do you fine, which means the remaining 24, you still get your own division. May as well get some leaders to learn a thing or two about combat. Expensive though it is on our PP. Perhaps unnecessarily so. So what am I going to do with you guys? Well, there is the threat that they could just take our capital and capitulate us, so for, at the very least for now, I would like you to strategically redeploy over here, and then set up a little fallback line that includes, oh, I don't know, these two at least. What do we have here? We just got plains and we got hills. It's all muddy though. Well, good enough. Jake, when you'll start the war, I hope you'll focus on false Mongols first. That was a bit of a problem that there's very little resistance I can offer here, but hey-ho. Okay, you guys need to stop training. It's unfortunate we weren't able to get you up to scratch yet. And it's funny that my general really doesn't think that this battle or this plan is going to go in our favor. Probably because there's a huge amount of entrenched Japanese troops right here. So I want all my units to get into position. Some may take longer than others. But that's okay, we have this war goal for a wee while. You guys have plans. You guys don't have plans. So I need to think where you guys are going to go. And... we'll just keep it nice and simple. Actually, that is nice and simple. Which means you fellows also need a plan. Also, Nice and simple, no further than the river. Plans are fairly useless, but planning? Now that's very valuable. Drawing this like a disabled toddler. There we go, good enough. Whoa, okay, what's going on now? Nobody has expected less than mutual contempt between us and the Japanese, but the animosity has intensified lately. It now appears that conflict will arise sooner rather than later. Crushing Japanese nationalism. Is there any more society more repugnant to the future of the revolution, any more alien to the plight of the worker, than the fascist regime of Japan? Okay. Sure. I know what that is. Not... Okay. Still want people to get into position before I pull the trigger. And what we have... Alright, we haven't finished our justification yet. For some reason I thought we had done it. A toast to our new German friends. Yes, well that keeps them off of our back at least. So there we go, we have this war goal until when exactly? 15th of August, so I don't have a lot of time, but thankfully my units are probably getting into position. There we go. Redeploy as fast as you can, then get your planning done. So why am I dispersing my units so thinly like this, considering that even a stiff breeze could murder them? And why am I not doing it over here? I have a few reasons. One is that until war starts, the Soviets are not going to reinforce my line, so the units I have here are mostly to hold out. There was no point putting units to hold out here, since they would get crushed. I would simply just lose lots of men with no real help. The Soviets will eventually, I assume, flood in to fill this out. I hope they do, otherwise I am in grave danger. So how's it looking for us politically? Fascists finally have a majority, which is good. And once our units are in position, I'll be ready to go. Not everyone will get their planning bonus, but that's alright. It's not like planning bonus means much for these one-horse divisions. The only good thing cavalry has are speed and... Oh my. Soviet Union is justifying against Finland. Please, please, please don't drag us into a war with the Allies. They're guaranteed by France, who is part of the Allies. That would be troublesome. Well, it's all the more reason for me to drop that faction like an ugly baby. However, I kind of need that, so I can just decline their call to arms. Or so I hope. Well, the joke would be if Finland joined the Axis. Don't think that would happen, though. We're not about to be at war with the Axis. So how are things going here? There are a lot of ways that this could go completely wrong. The common sense inside of me was telling... me to instead go for... Oh, I don't like this. They are going to the wrong place right now. I need them here. Then again, the Japanese also seem to have abandoned the border with them whilst... Oh, dear. There's a lot of ways this could go wrong. There are a ton of ways this could go wrong. We have a total of one of our generals who think we have a plan that's worth doing. Jake, are you Stalin's puppet? No, we are in the same faction, though. I really, really hope that the Soviets join in on this, or else I'm gonna die. Which is quite funny. Well, let's just do it. The thing is, I can't just drop them out of my faction, or else supply will go down the toilet. Maybe I could offer military access when all's said and done, but... Well, Tanatuva joined in. Phew, they do want to. They're allied with me and they don't like Japan. Good, please join in. If you don't, I'm going to die. So straight away, our Japanese friends decide that attacking us is what they want to do. We should be able to hold out here. We're not terribly entrenched because we don't have any engineers or such. Boy, I wish I did, but I'm still... don't think I'm even researching those. Wish I could get tech sharing as well. There's a lot of things I wish. But I'm not about to get them. Okay, so what does this mean? It means you folks, you have a very clear border here. I would like you to engage and make your way down there. There are also you folks who do not think you can do this. I want for you to do it anyway. The Soviet state of Yunnan, the monastic commune of Tibet, Chinese People's Republic, they're all joining in. I don't think they have a troop between them. And yeah, this does mean that I'm pretty much going to be sacrificing Guangzhou and Shandong. Which probably means I should recruit all their population before they just get absorbed. Oh well, that's terrible news. I didn't think Japan would... Okay, I did not expect that to happen. Maybe I should have, but the Japanese tend not to join in or bring in extras. Oh well, inadvertently caused World War II, that was a poor decision. So much for that pact. Okay, this is pretty bad news. Then again, as long as the German Reich don't cleave their way through Poland, there's nothing to immediately worry about here. There is something to worry about if you also declare war on Finland, causing, well, lots of bad things. Also means that I can't leave your faction now, because we're fighting a big war against a faction. Oh well, what's done is done. There is a slight problem that what I could be doing is just giving all this land back to the Chinese People's Republic. That would be very bad for me. This is also pretty bad. We're getting slaughtered here. Alright, well, at the very least I can change away from being communist and start becoming fascists. Fascist becomes a ruling party. Done and done right. Welcome to the dawn of the new Mongol Empire, and now I can finally start going down my milk the population as much as I can route. Still in the faction with you. Can't leave it though. Can't leave it until this enormous war is over. But oh, this is terrifying. Come on, where is your... Wait, which one is it? There it is, warrior code, AI modifier, call ally desire minus 40. Doesn't seem to have worked out for us. They've called every ally they have. Well, this is going to be troublesome. I can only hope that the German Reich ends up in a big problem with the Allies, but I don't think that's going to happen. For one, the Nationalists won in Spain. But by driving up world tension, I will have also unlocked a lot of Allied actions. Oh well, interesting. The Mongol Empire has screwed the pooch here. And this is even worse. I am giving this land back to the People's Republic of China. All these core states I might not be able to get for myself. I mean, the occupation score still goes to me, but I don't know what that's going to mean at the peace table. Oh well. We can but try. Okay, there are also all these units of mine that are probably going to die on this line. Yeah, look at them, they're just burning away because they're attacking people that they are unable to reasonably fight. So we'll hold you off on that. There are also you folks. Yeah, your plan might be better to hold as well. We'll see how it goes. Yeah, this is why going through the Afghanistan-Iran part... Wait, what? The Soviet Union is called Poland as our ally in the... Poland has joined the Comintern. German Reich has declared war on Poland. Yes. Of course. Oh man. I took this the wrong way. Alright, so there's quite a few things about this that is not going to be going my way. I wonder if anything can go my way now. Maybe a brilliant cutoff of the enemy here is in order. I don't think that's going to work whatsoever, but I'm desperate. So participation is going to be a constant concern for me. Because if I don't do much, then I'm going to have the same problem as before of me, oh, well, that's something I want. Oh, that was mine anyway, and I just let it go. That's a shame. Just goes to show how poor my troops are. Hold on, here's a thought. Occupation 24. When I go in there in 2 days, damn, that's pretty slow for a horse. Okay, infrastructure's pretty low. Apparently there's a river. Occupation is at 25, but I want to see what happens when I take this. That's interesting. Assuming I didn't take anything else of note, that's very interesting. Might be able to game that in the future. Okay, did I have some kind of grand plan here? I think it already fell through. You know, what I really like is that some of these used to be full divisions and they're already cut down. This is showing that units of mine that have been completely destroyed in combat. So that's pretty bad news for me. They get attacked and they just get destroyed. Oh dear. If the Soviets gun down Finland, then we're going to be at war with the Allies as well, and that's going to be very bad. This is also very bad. They are just pushing through like we're not even there. Then again, Chengdu is sitting there like it's not even there. Give me Chengdu. Our soft attack is utterly horrific. Barely even exists. But for the love of God, give me Chengdu. I fought so hard for Chongqing and did not get it. This time, though, mine for sure. Not so happy about the tragic number of losses I have here, though, so I think I'll have to recall some of these just to flesh out my units. Excellent, at least we got Chongqing for now. We then have to defend it. Defending on horseback is apparently not very easy. With no organization. Barely any equipment left. We were able to push these guys out. Let's keep pushing. At least the Soviets will back us along a lot of this. The Polish might actually survive this one, but here's the trouble. If Poland's not joining the Allies, then are the Allies even going to get involved in World War II against the Germans? If we attack Finland, they're going to get involved against us, and the Axis are just going to get like a free pass. I don't honestly think the Japanese are scared of my horsemen. You know, look at this crap. But this is punishing. Taking the land, but just giving it back to the Chinese People's Republic because they have cores there. That really was a clever move by the Soviets, all things considered. Still want Chongqing, but they're not going to give it to me. Not easily, at least. Oops, that was not intentional. Not intentional. Don't want you to run away from there. What I do want is Chongqing. Hold and crush. Oh well, much as I want it, it's actually occupied by them, so I won't get the resources, I won't get the manpower. All I'll get is crippling disappointment. I will, however, learn a lesson about this. And if I can come out of this a wiser man, then that's all the better. Does that mean we sound less like a sore loser? Okay, I need this manpower. My manpower is burning, I rather. Oh my days, I don't have those kind of casualties to afford. This is the tricky part of having no real defense and no real offense. Well, that's troublesome. Well, it is what it is. I still really want Chongqing. They're not going to give it to me, are they? Not without a fight. Jake, can you ask for control of a state? I can, but it's so incredibly unlikely to happen. For example, okay, they don't have any states they're willing to, or they even can give away. They do not control enough occupied territory to want to give it away. Okay. Otherwise, though? Otherwise they would. They trust my judgment. Interesting that somebody would actually say that about me, but there you go. Okay, this entire war is going to go terribly, because the Soviets are going to be overextended here. Well, the Poles certainly are. There are a lot of ways that this is going to go particularly badly. I had assumed that the Japanese might have joined the Axis, but I did not anticipate them actually calling the Axis in. This is one of the worrying things, though. Oh, they have a lot more divisions there than I thought. We're being attacked from multiple ends here, so we are just going to die. Let's fall back to something a bit more defendable. Strange that our horses don't fight super well on open plains, but then we are playing by Hearts of Iron rules. Good night, Poland. They never stood a chance. Lesson zero of cavalry only. Don't. I refuse to believe that. Alright, I still want Chongqing, though. Just let these guys get their bearings together. I'm just going to have to cancel all of this. I need that manpower for reinforcement. What are you doing there? I want you to go here. You got all your planning bonus? Crush it. Well, at least we're going full nationalist now. I need that extra manpower. Boy, do I need that extra manpower. I think all adults will have to serve pretty soon. I lost a lot of my iron, I think. Yep. So there goes a lot of my production, too. It takes so much, even to clear out a few of these guys. Any dream of swiftly beating Japan is down the toilet. And I can see at the bottom of my screen a lot of my divisions are getting outright destroyed here. Not much left of these guys, and there's no real way to push in here. Well, we tried that, didn't work out so well. They're just holding onto land that is ours. Fortunately, I have some backup, but it's all just one-horse divisions who aren't able to effectively attack. But hey, I have a dream. A dream of Mongol Chongqing. Jake, we're gonna need all ponies, sir. Where are we even getting all these horses? Okay, at least our manpower is almost stabilized. Still lost a tragic number. At least I'm grinding out that casualty war score. But for every division he adds to somewhere that I attack, it just is inconceivably increases the amount of work I have to do. Just to take it. Also, I think I'm gonna need more steel from Daddy Stalin here. It's not that my military factories are doing much of note. The benefit of playing like this is that when I go back to not going cavalry only, I'm gonna feel unstoppable. So there you go, give me Chongqing. It's mine by birthright. You maintain that though, please. Alright, he's trying to take Chongqing, or reinforce it rather. I'm the one trying to take it, but I'm afraid it is mine, not yours. But there's the sad thing, it's... Oh no, it is in our control. That's funny, I thought it would be in... the PR... Hmm? Yeah, People's Republic. Oh well, if it's in my control, then whoop-de-doo, does that mean I get the steel now? Well, I seem to have some extra, so I'll assume so. Heh. Well, that's for as long as I maintain this, which might not be very long. We're not even able to hold on to Chongqing getting attacked here. Good lord, that Japan is scary. Alright, I'm wondering if it's worth keeping on going down this, or if there's anything else better for me to research. A bit of encryption might give me some bonus in fighting. Oh, this is hopelessly bad. It's just that feeling of I've made a terrible mistake overwhelming me. Because if I'd gone the safer western path, then I would not currently be staring at 69,000 dead horses. I think the Japanese are really pulling their finger out as well. Whilst the Soviets are... Oh, they're going to struggle. They are going to struggle a lot. There we go. Just losing Chongqing there. Tragic. Alright, militarism giving us that extra recruitable population that is going to be so good. I want even more, so we're getting military youth. And I would like to make all horses serve, but do I even have the guns to give them? I have a lot of infantry equipment, but a lot of it is old crappy weapons. Oh, this is poor. I've already lost a lot of ground to the Japanese. And the Soviets are not going to be able to push this. I've seen the Soviets fight in Japan, it's not pretty. Oof. And that's where it gets even worse. My horse is fighting an armored unit. There is no way in this game my horses would ever be able to pierce an armored unit. Because, sadly, even the anti-tank is infantry only. All infantry motorized and mechanized. Does not include cavalry. I should just strap some wheels to my cavalry and then count them as motorized or mechanized. End up looking like a very uncanny Wally. Oh, hello, my German friends. I've seen you before. Will you later liberate the world as Liberia, Jake? Yes, Liberia is on the cards. Okay. Well, at the very least, my plan of subtly destroying the Soviet Union is coming into great effect. Because they're so concentrated over here, they just cannot stand up to that German barrage. At least they haven't gone for Finland, though. They've been almost clever about that. Everybody has a very bad opinion of the Soviet Union. Okay. This is just plain bad. In fact, they've taken so many casualties that they've lost a lot of their training as well. So goodbye any seasoned or veteran units. In fact, has one of them been kicked down to green? That's tragic. This is scary. A lot of you guys are about to get cut off here as well. And I had an army up here once. It's gone now. Okay, I'm low on ideas here. Cut off and destroyed. This is giving me a very Golden Horde feeling. The difference was I actually won in Golden Horde. With this, victory looks bleak. Good fight, good night. One horse. Hey, he's the last man standing, though. Well, except for the reserve, which just for some reason didn't want to join in. Well, we teach our young how to ride horses, and they can go and die for us as well. The Soviet Union have gotten well ahead of us in the losses grinding here. Man, I even took Chongqing and I couldn't hold it. Must be a way to make horses better at defending. Total base defense is pretty poor, but you could probably augment that with some entrenchment. Doesn't give defense in its own, but an extra entrenchment. Romania now stands significantly politically weakened. What a shame for them. Actually, Germany's on a rampage. I think I might just sit back and watch the carnage that I've caused, whilst feeling a little bad for me and my horses. Forever Lona says, Jake, don't usually catch you online. Quick shout out for the streams. Love your work. Okay, because my population doesn't love my work today. Okay, well, it's accepted when I do runs that things don't always go particularly well, but important lessons were learned. Do not trigger against Japan so swiftly. They'll join the Axis and kill you. If I had gone west... Well, it would have been difficult fighting these guys, but would have been within my abilities rather than all of this. Sad part is, though, if I want to do over, I think I'd be starting from the start. I hate saves coming anyway, so I would. Might take a while, though. When you lose, are you going to start a new campaign, or will you continue, Jake? Continue being taking a second stab at this? I think I would take a second stab at this. I really want to make all cavalry work. I mean, there is no conceivable way to actually reasonably be able to charge into the enemy and comfortably win with all cavalry. And look at this, I'm fighting three divisions with eight, and I'm losing. And just adding more horses is not the answer, though. I mean, sure, I could get myself up to combat width of horses, but I'm almost already there. And it's just barely helping. Don't believe that estimate, it's not going to take less than a day. But part of it is I didn't allow myself to build up with what I had for very long, so that could be down as part of it. Okay. I probably wouldn't change a thing up until declaring war on Japan, but I really want to try this again. Oh well, at the very least, I can sit back and watch Germany murder the Soviets. Will you accept other people's input into how to make it slightly more workable, Cav only, Jake? Well, Zwer, of course I would. But a big part of the fun is finding out for oneself. You're going to need to add anti-tanks and artillery for this to work. Ah, but that's cheating. That takes away the cavalry-only part of it. I mean, if I really wanted to cheese it, what I would be doing is... I would be giving myself a whole load of one cavalry units and stacking them with anti-tank, artillery, and rocket artillery. But then it would just be like one guy on a horse commanding all the real units, and that's not what we're going for here. Then again, with all these horses dying, one can wonder, what am I going for here? How is Soviet Union's national unity? If it's 90%, this is going to take a while. It's 75. That's not going to make it take less of a while, though. It's still going to take ages. But I don't know, maybe there are some Germans in the chat watching this going, yes, yes! The German equivalent of that's it, man. As is often the case, the sad music is playing in my defeat. At least the Chinese people have capitulated, but that means this land is just going back to them. But that was important to learn as well. If I have somebody in the war that has all these cores, then it's going to go to them. Probably to do with me being in that faction. There are penalties for having too many low combat width divisions taking part in a battle, so that wouldn't be so overpowered. Really? Not something I'm aware of. I know there's stacking penalty, but I guess that's not part of it. Would make sense for there to be some kind of organizational difficulties, though. At least the Soviet Union are closer to capitulating than I am, but they really are grinding out that casualty stat. Oh, and they're the only major faction member here. That is interesting, actually. Maybe I shouldn't be throwing in the towel just yet. Another part of it is maybe I should be pulling my units away from here before they just die. Or maybe even just dismissing them. I get all the everything back from it, so that's okay. You guys need to stay there. I would actually like to defend my capital, please. What of you guys? You guys still know a thing or two. What I would like is for you to, let's see, all of you are going to make it there. I'm going to have you strategically redeploy over there. Except, yeah, that actually gets everybody out of there. The Soviets can still maintain the line there. Heavily fortified areas of the Soviet Union continuing to fall, as I kind of laugh. Not sure if I'm laughing or crying at this stage, but something is happening. And maybe sieve factories would be more useful at this point. Maybe. Maybe. quite choking the supply here. Good. But this means that when the Soviet Union falls, they as faction leader fall, not me. Oh shoot, I do like to make this mistake, don't I? Get rid of this. You guys have one thing to do, and that is run away. Good, they got no plan now. Jake, join the fascists first. Maybe that'll work. If I go down the kill Soviet route before I go down the kill the Chinese route, that might be better. I had this lovely idea that the Japanese would be too unstructured. But then the 120 days I give them whilst I fabricate war is more than enough for them to flesh out a defense. And even if they weren't, they would have enough time to run along and make a wall. Doesn't really matter if the wall were here, here, or even here. It's still a wall of Japanese people that I just cannot fight my way through. Because my cavalry is just atrocious. And again, the Germans seem to be stretching a bit much here. The Netherlands have joined the Comintern now. It's getting a bit crowded here. Jake, do you have a fort on your capital? I don't think I put a fort on my capital. Denmark and Norway join the Allies? Some strange stuff going on here. Assassination of Leon Trotsky is either barbaric or a fitting end. I get that because I'm both fascist and part of the Comintern. Multiple options. Might as well grab that extra tech slot whilst I still can. Who knows if it'll come in handy? I don't. I don't think the AI ever accepts an offer piece. Not 1,000,000% sure, but I don't think they do. Okay. Need to rethink what to do then, because this isn't going to last as long as I'd imagined, provided things go the way they're probably going to go. You're being flanked through Tibet, Jake. Well, I took away all my defenses, so I'm hardly surprised. Dark time. Besides, it's barely me being flanked. Well, hold on, how did you get there? They probably walked over there, but then got cut off. Interesting.